Hey guys, welcome to Wednesday Math. This is the website, so this is the page. This is the video you're watching right now, Wednesday, May 13th. And here's Wednesday's to-do list. So first thing, watch today's video and you're doing that. So thumbs up. Complete the Google form from last Thursday. That's the link right over here. That was almost a week ago. So if you haven't done that yet, just do it. It's not for marks, but it is helping me to see who's engaging, who's not. It's just simple probability. It helps me to plan future lessons, right? See who's doing it and who's having trouble and who's getting it. Then finish yesterday's work, page 241. That was this down here, right? Which is the same as this right here because it's got more than one page. Trending pop-ups. And then read page 243, 244. There's not a lot of reading. We'll look at that together. And then complete questions 1, 2, and 3. So there's only three questions for today. And it won't take you very long to do those. So let's click on here to start, open this up. This was yesterday's work. I already talked about this to some extent, right? And I'll pop an answer key up there for tomorrow. So if you haven't got that done, make sure it gets done. And then 243 is, it's called the use of tree diagrams. And this is an easier way to sort out some of the things we've done already. Like when I was explaining on the board yesterday, if you toss a coin and you roll a die, you can have a heads and a one, heads and a two, heads and a three, heads and a four. And you can list that H1, H2, H3, H4. Or you can shortcut it, right? Here's heads and all the possible outcomes from heads. So you can have heads and a one, heads two, heads three, heads four, heads five, six. Or you can have a tails and a one, two, three. So you can see there's 12 different outcomes. There's six for heads and six for tails. So it just, instead of writing all of this out, which is fine, you can write all that out. You can shortcut it to this, okay? And it's the same with a spinner. So here's a tree diagram to show the spinner. It would be C, and then you'd have, I can't write on this page here, C, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, and then A, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then B, 1, 2, 3, 4, or A starting with it, because it makes sense, start with A. A, 1, 2, 3, 4, B, 1, 2, 3, 4, C, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the example's right here, right? A, 1, 2, 3, 4, B, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can see all 12 different outcomes, right? A, 1, A, 2, B, 1, B, 2, C, 3, C, 4, okay? So you can list them like this, like we've been doing in the past, or you can shortcut it like this. Just quick and easy example, okay? And then this is the question I want you to do, the three questions. This is the first one. Use a tree diagram to show what happened when you have a nickel and a penny. So you could have, you'd have heads and tails for the nickel, and then you'd have heads and then tails for the penny, right? Heads and tails for the nickel. So this would be divided into two, heads and then tails, and each one of those would be divided into two, okay? Or you could have the heads and tails, or 1, 2, 3, 4. So this penny would be divided into heads and tails, and then from the heads, you'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, and the tails, you'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? The dice and the spinner. So for here, you would have this divided into six, right? You'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then each one of those, you'd have green, blue, red, green, blue, red. 1, green, blue, red. 2, green, blue, red. And that's the way you would set up that diagram, okay? You can work ahead if you want on these ones, but that's the work for tomorrow, okay? So I'll pop an answer key up tomorrow for the stuff that we did yesterday and today. But that's it. That's all I want you working on. So have a good rest of your day. If you have any questions, make sure you're coming to see me in Google Meet. Other than that, we'll talk to you guys on Thursday at our team meeting. Remember, it's Thursday, not Friday, because Friday's Pro Day. Take care, everyone.